Tonight, One Championship celebrates its 100th event in epic style. The best of the best are in action. World champions versus world champions in the biggest bouts on two stacked cards. It's the single biggest martial arts event in history. With world titles on the line and the World Grand Prix Championships at stake, it's an explosive night of action unlike any other. One Century Part 2, live from Tokyo, Japan, starts now. You're watching the best of One Championship. One Championship returned to Tokyo, Japan with One Century, the biggest martial arts event in history, featuring two shows in one day. Let's take a look at the martial arts spectacle of One Century, Part 2. In the main event of the night, one heavyweight world champion Brandon Vera challenged two Division I world champion Aung La N Sang for the one light heavyweight world title. Let's join this match of epic proportions in round two.
Brandon Vera hasn't been into the second round of a match since 2013. More than 6 years ago, it's been all standing so far. We haven't gone to the ground. On the ground, Vera has one sub. Aung La has 12 submissions, 5 guillotines, 5 arm bars included.
Yeah, Michael, I don't know if this is going to go to the ground. I think these guys want to put on a show, and they are looking for a knockdown.
Just a slip there for Aung La. Overhand right. He can't afford to get sloppy because I believe Vera beats him for speed and precision. Outside leg kick to that common peroneal nerve just above the lead knee from Aung La.
Every time Brandon's in orthodox, Aung La N Sang's touching that lead leg, and you can see beautiful check there.
You see the Baybayin Filipino writing on the back of Brandon Vera as Aung La backs him up with a hook.
Oh, that leg kick, that's Vera. Trying to do damage, Michael.
Oh, Muay Thai clinch and knee, and Aung La's been caught. There's the uppercut. He uncorked the uppercut. He uncorked the uppercut, but it doesn't drop Vera. It dropped Hasegawa. It knocked Hasegawa out, but not Vera.
Both these guys got iron chins. They are eating each other's best shots, and they're still standing. It's going to take a remarkable effort to put one of these two monsters down.
Step through knee from Vera. After he threw a crossing elbow, Aung La comes forward, always plodding forward. He wants to drill the steel pipe to the jaw. Both men in southpaw starts.
Those low kicks are starting to touch Brandon. You can see how he's taking them. He's stepping gingerly on those legs.
The low kicks will slow down the boxing of Brandon Vera. Vera tries the Muay Thai clinch and knee, hoping for the meet and greet. Inside leg there from Aung La. Got to watch that drift away lead hook of Brandon Vera. It's what he knocked out Mauro Cirilli with. What's the gas tank like of Brandon Vera at light heavyweight in the second round? Round kick from Vera.
Now he's starting to move. Beautiful little roundhouse kick to a straight left hand there, landed by Vera. Aung La N Sang seems unfazed by the power. He's wearing these punches very well.
Aung La eats a stiff left hand from Brandon and continues to come forward, slings the legs again.
Again with a big leg kick. You can see Brandon starting to get a little bit wobbly. I don't know if these are hurting him though. Again.
Outside leg kick. That lead leg of Vera has taken tremendous punishment. Body shot from Aung La. Got to be careful, that drift away hook. There's the left hook from Vera. There's the uppercut. Another left hook, but Aung La caught him. And the high kick. The one that knocked out Machado to win the light heavyweight crown. Beautiful. Toe to toe now. Two warriors. Two athletes. Two world champions.
Oh, those elbows. Brandon Vera looks wobbled.
Oh, Vera.
Comes
it's
in,
the rubber legs.
Elbow.
He's on rubber legs. Aung La's caught him. Spinning back elbow. Vera, spinning back elbow. Aung La's cut.
The elbow's ready to go. Brandon goes down.
Vera's ready to go. It's going bananas. It's insane. It's insanity. It's good. Nine. Freaking Irene. Aung La's done it again. Myanmar is going crazy. Tokyo goes into a meltdown. That was bananas. He knocked out Vera.
Wow, what an amazing finish for Aung La N Sang. And the Rocky movie now has a sequel, Michael Stavello.
Look at this. You can see Brandon Vera was starting to wobble just ever so slightly, but then look at the spinning back elbow connects to the side of the head. Brandon Vera thought about answering with one of his own. He crumbles to the ground, and Aung La jumps all over him, and he just starts landing big punches. Look at the left hands. Olivier Coste was forced to call a halt to the action because Aung La was just letting it go.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 23 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of technical knockout, and still one light heavyweight world champion, Aung La N Sang!
Amazing scenes here in Tokyo. An amazing performance from Aung La N Sang. You cosmic kite, where did you come from? Myanmar's national hero, their national treasure, their only world champion of anything, and still world champion in the middleweight and light heavyweight divisions.
Pancrase lightweight world champion Takasuke Kume's right hand landed early and often against the Shudo lightweight world champion Koshi Matsumoto. After an accidental clash of heads toward the end of the first round, Kume scrambled for a rear naked choke. Matsumoto took control on the ground for much of the second stanza, but Kume was dominant again in the final minutes of the bout. That late dominance seemed to make the difference for Kume, who took the unanimous decision victory. Shinya Aoki was the hometown hero once again in Tokyo as he faced former one featherweight world champion Honorio Bonario.
Aoki, the former police cadet, 31 career finishes, 27 in the first round. The fastest ever for Aoki, 49 seconds over. Toshikatsu Arada back in 2013 at Inoki Bombaye. Honorio Bonario, 6 first round finishes. Last one back in December 2016 against Rajinder Singh Mina in 4 minutes and 4.
This is exactly what Honorio Bonario did not want. He did not want Shinya Aoki to get his arms around his body and start pulling him in to this takedown attempt right here. Look at him trying to elevate, trying to off balance Honorio Bonario.
Aoki knows how to finish opponents, hasn't gone to a decision since his win over Koji Ando in May 2015 in Singapore. And this is Aoki land.
Oh, beautifully done. Look how he snuck that arm in there looking for that choke. Now he's got a baseball bat choke. Now he switches into a dart.
Oh, this could be the beginning of the end. Oh, for Honorio Bonario, the rock in a whole lot above it now. Aoki twist, Aoki turned. It's good night, Irene! Aoki does it again. The man is a genius.
Wow. Lightning fast submission from Toby Kanjudan as Shinya jumps over the cage inside. Right back to where he started, plants himself. Big deep breaths. One of the best to ever do it, Michael.
28 first round finishes in 44 career wins. 28 submissions now. It's about a 75% finishing rate. The former Shooter World Champion, former Wemmer World Champion, former Dream Lightweight World Champion, and former One Lightweight World Champion taps out another former World Champion with ease, with style. Let's go to Tom Lau. Make it all official.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 54 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of Darce Choke, Shinya Aoki!
A Darce Choke finish for Aoki. Won his first world title in 2006. 13 years later, winning on the biggest martial arts show in history.
Coming up after the break, Bibiano Fernandez defends his one bantamweight world title. You're watching the Best of One Championship. Welcome back to the Best of One Championship. One Century featured the closing chapter of the biggest rivalry in ONE history. ONE Bantamweight World Champion Bibiano Fernandez faced off against former ONE World Champion Kevin Bellingon in their fourth encounter. We join the action in round two.
Ready, go!
Second round of five. For the bantamweight world title held by Bibiano Fernandez. He's on the right of your screen. Kevin Bellingon, the former world champion, in the red trunks, left of screen. Flicking a high kick there from Bibiano. Goes downstairs, clash of shins.
Again, look at that, catches the body kick, gets nice and tight, presses him up against the cage. Now he's able to circle, to drop down, change levels, and start attacking those legs. Kevin's got to split the legs and create a little bit better defense. Otherwise, Bibiano's going to take those legs, suck them in. It's very important that he doesn't allow him to clasp the hands like he's doing right now. Because once Bibiano gets the hands clasped together, he's able to do a lot more work.
Elbows coming from the wushu stylist Bellingon.
Oh, sacrifice throw there for Bibiano. Beautiful roll through to end up on top and inside control. That's a very important position to be in. That was a beautiful takedown from Bibiano Fernandez.
Fernandez, who won BJJ gold at the World Championships in 2003, 2005, 2006.
Look at this. This is old school Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu right here. He's got the shoulder controlled on one side and he's got the arm near the hip. This is gonna flatten Kevin out and not enable him to go anywhere. Now he's hooking the leg. Now he's gonna try to press that leg out, and he might be looking. Oh, look at that! He's softening the knee up, softening the leg up with knees.
Knees to the hamstring, the sciatic nerve. Kevin Bellingon. You talk old school, and Bibiano Fernandez began his pro career in October 2004, competing in the legendary jungle fight in Manaus in the Amazon. And here he is at the very top of the martial arts world, still, some 15 years later. As the defending bantamweight world champion takes the back of Bellingon.
Beautiful, that's how he got the nickname, the Flash. One minor mistake and Bibiano jumps all over the back.
Hooks are in. Bellingon in trouble now, the figure four around the body. Bellingon in trouble.
Oh, Kevin's got to defend the hands. He can't let the hands go clasp the clasp.
Oh, that's good night, Irene! That's good night, Irene! Bibiano's done it! He's tapped out Bellingon again!
To defend his one bantamweight world championship. What a finish. That right there, ladies and gentlemen, was textbook Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Look at this. Look at this control. The way he was able to take that back, that's how he earned the nickname The Flash. Lightning quick movement. Gets nice and deep. You can see the chin. You can see the chin's the only thing protecting Kevin Bellingon right there from that choke. But Bibiano, being that world-class jiu-jitsu practitioner, was able to go palm to palm and sets the squeeze in. And Bibiano Fernandez has a tremendous squeeze.
Fernandez said that Bellingon could not match him on the ground. It proved true. And that certainly must close the chapter on this epic rivalry. Let's go to Tom Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 16 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of rear naked choke and still one bantamweight world champion, Filipino.
As a young boy, he grew up in abject poverty in the Amazon jungle, fending for food, building shelters to cover himself from the storms. And now Bibiano again stands on top of the sporting world.
Giorgio Petrosian faced off against Sammy Sanna for the one featherweight kickboxing World Grand Prix Championship. Midway through the first round, Petrosian started opening up and cracked his foe with his trademark right hook straight left combination. The man from Milan upped the ante in the second round as he landed his best shots of the contest. The five-time kickboxing world champion continued to frustrate Sanna by gliding away from his strikes, and he connected with the biggest combination of the night as a hook and uppercut found their mark. The Frenchman knew he was behind on the scorecards, so he pushed forward in the final 3 minutes and let his hands go in search of a knockout. It was too little, too late in the end, as Petrosian got the unanimous decision victory. Mei Yamaguchi faced a familiar foe as she took on Jenny Huang. Yamaguchi walked through some impressive striking by Huang to continually bring the match to the ground. Despite Huang's efforts, she could not find a decisive strike, and the final bell brought a unanimous decision for Yamaguchi. Arjun Bular got his one championship campaign off to a perfect start in his heavyweight battle with Mauro Cirilli. The Commonwealth Games wrestling gold medalist displayed the versatility of his skill set as he outboxed his Italian rival en route to a unanimous decision win. Coming up after the break, one flyweight Muay Thai world champion Rodtang Jitmuangnon defends his belt for the very first time. You're watching The Best of One Championship. Welcome back to The Best of One Championship. One flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon, defended his belt for the first time against three-time Muay Thai world champion, Walter Goncalves. We join the heated battle in the fifth and final round.
Fifth and final round, still anyone for the taking, okay, for the one Super Series flyweight Muay Thai World Championship. There's the champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon. And what a moment of honor to kick off this championship round. The southpaw Walter Goncalves of Brazil giving Rodtang a contest unlike anything we've seen before here in one Super Series. Clinching knees early.
You can see he's looking for that again. Nice little trip there. Good balance shown by Goncalves. Now, what Rodtang was complaining about is you're not allowed to pick somebody up and then throw them. That's what he was questioning the referee about.
Rodtang edging forward. Fake there from Goncalves. Two-punch combination. Gets out of the range of the counter right hand. Knees from Rodtang, that one to the lower spine, not permitted. Referee Dilapsis breaks them. Rodtang comes forward again. He wants a brawl with Goncalves. Goncalves refuses to be suckered in. Oh, question mark kick. AKA Brazilian kick, which is fitting from a Brazilian. Great Brazilian kickboxers and Muay Thai athletes over the years, the likes of Glaube Feitosa, of course, one's own Cosmo Alessandre, Francisco Filio. Rodtang backing up Goncalves, scooping bolo punch into the midsection. High kick there from Rodtang. It's time for Goncalves to start landing some scoring shots now.
Backing up still, he's got good head movement, he's evaded a lot of the power shots, but he's not getting suckered in by the psychological games of Rodtang.
Overhand elbow from Goncalves, double forearms guard against the round kick. Rodzang continually on the front foot.
Wow.
Rodzang was complaining about the throw off a dump earlier, but how about that from Rodzang? Tying him up in almost a choke there. Left hook from Rodzang. Roundhouse kick. Good counter right hand from Goncalves. Southpaw stance has gone to orthodox now, Goncalves, and it's working for him.
Man, that right hand slips right through the guard. It's scoring heavily from Goncalves.
Spinning back elbow, and Rodzang got underneath it. Switching stance, Goncalves just trying to confound Rodzang a little more. 30 seconds remaining. Final round. Rodzang playing to the crowd. But he's going to engage.
He's trying to push forward, but Goncalves just slides out of the way, ends up on the other side of the circle, evading all counter shots.
A very frustrating contest for Rodzang Jitmuangnon. Walter Goncalves' introduction to one super series will win him a lot of fans. And there it is. We are going down to the judges here in Tokyo. And they're both they're both posing in center circle, mirroring each other. Look at this.
Man, that's a pretty close matchup there, Michael Civello.
Who's gonna get off the fence first? Let's see.
Michael Civello, let's take a look at that kick that Goncalves landed. Beautifully timed, look at that. Sets it up with the push kick, switches stances, and then boom, just goes up and then comes right back down. He landed it with the push kick, look at him. Throws the push kick. He looks like he's gonna throw it again when he switches the stance. Look at this, brings it up and then wraps that foot right around the face of Rodtang. Oh, now we get to see who's the new flyweight Muay Thai world champion.
Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number 1 calls this contest in favor of the blue corner. Judge number 2 calls this contest in favor of the red corner. And judge number 3 calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision. And still one flyweight Muay Thai world champion.
Tong places the strap over the shoulder of Rodzang. And look at the moments of honor. Goncalves can't believe it. Rodzang pays his respects, saying that Goncalves a formidable opponent. The strap stays in Thailand. The strap stays with the Ironman Rodzang Jitmuangnon.
Shudo welterweight world champion Hernani Perpetuo opened his match with Hiroyuki Tetsuka using his jabs and hard kicks. The Pancrase welterweight world champion returned fire with hard hooks to the body and engaged toe-to-toe. In the third, Tetsuka upped the intensity with his punches and elbows from top position, and his late offensive on the ground was enough to earn a unanimous decision. Shudo bantamweight world champion Shoko Sato put a stop to Rafael Silva with his outstanding striking. An onslaught of punches in the second round earned him a tremendous knockout finish.
Takes a big knee to the head, and the left and rights are coming in now. The referee's looking very carefully indeed. Sato is unloading, and Silva is offering nothing back in return. Oh. He's looking very wobbly indeed.
He's ready to go.
The referee's still poised. He's gone down, and now he jumps in, and it's over. Sato takes it in the second round, and this crowd goes crazy.
The former one strawweight world champion, Yosuke Tsuruta, hit Daiichi Kitakata with a stunning second round knockout.
Stalemate there, holding the wrist.
Oh,
now punches,
he's out.
And he's out. He's out, Gianni. The first punch seemed to just phase him completely, and then the remaining 3 were perhaps even unnecessary.